Also today, the parents of the Florida teen whose shooting death caused a national outcry about racial profiling were in the Crescent City today. Now, this comes as new evidence is being released in the Trayvon Martin case. George Zimmerman's firsthand account of what happened the night he shot and killed Florida teen Trayvon Martin is now public. Take a look at this. This is reenactment filmed by Sanford, Florida police the day after Martin was shot and killed. Zimmerman took them through what happened, saying Martin was walking in the grassy area before he came at Zimmerman, punched him in the nose, and slammed his head against the concrete. That's when Zimmerman said he shot the teen in self-defense. Martin's parents and their lawyers have questioned Zimmerman's memory, especially when it comes to the events of that night. This morning, they were in New Orleans attending the National Association of Black Journalists convention. They spoke about the death of their son and their mission to prevent this from happening to any other family. WDSU anchor Sulla Kim was there. She has the story all new at 6.
The family of Trayvon Martin took part in a panel discussion here at the NABJ conference. They talked about how social media is playing an ongoing role in the social and cultural implications of their situation.
God, no other person could help us at this time. I mean, it was the lowest time of my life.
Sabrina Fulton shares how painful life has been since her son Trayvon Martin was shot to death. Police say the 17-year-old was gunned down in Sanford, Florida by George Zimmerman, a Neighborhood Watch volunteer. Trayvon was not armed and Zimmerman was not charged until months later.
It was the saddest moment of my life.
In the midst of their grief, the family was thrown into the spotlight as national debates sparked on racial profiling and gun laws.
It's so many things could have happened to us if we had not did what we did, but we felt that we had to be the spokesperson for our son.
Meanwhile, Wednesday, Sanford's police chief Bill Lee got fired for his handling of the case, and newly released video in the murder trial shows Zimmerman's side of the story. The family says they just want justice for their son and want the media to stop portraying him as a thug.
Trayvon had no criminal history.
There's a lot of media out there that wants to betray Trayvon. His image is bad. They try to smear his image.
And we want to be able to help another family so that this doesn't happen to them.
The Martins say it's a difficult time, but they're going to remain strong and speak up for justice and for their child. On your side, Sulla Kim, WDSU News.
The Martins' attorneys were also at the conference. George Zimmerman has been charged with second-degree murder.